If you, like me, share an interest in nuclear energy, then you will surely like my other hobby. I like to find and view various nuclear objects on satellite images. But I am primarily interested in nuclear power plants, of course. Therefore, I decided to make the first video with such a view from the space of a large nuclear power plant. For example, I took one of the largest nuclear power plants in the world, the Chinese nuclear power plant Fuqing. To be precise, this is number 6 on the list of the largest nuclear power plants in the world and number 3 in China itself. There are 6 units with a total capacity of 6,150 megawatts. This is more than any nuclear power plant in the US or Europe. Even the largest nuclear power plant in Europe, the Ukrainian Zaporizhzhia nuclear power plant, which is now captured by Russia, is a little smaller. I have a separate video about the Zaporizhzhia NPP nuclear risks associated with its capture. You can watch it at the link, it is now on the screen. But the Fuqing nuclear power plant is remarkable not only for its size. It is interesting that at the end of 2021, the first Chinese reactor of the third generation of its own design, the Hualong 1 power unit, was put into operation on it. Of course, it is based on the French designs of previous generations that were built in China. But China builds a lot and learns fast. Let me remind you that now China has the second largest nuclear fleet in the world, second only to the American one, almost all of which was built over the past 20 years. So, of course, the Chinese modern water-cooled reactor project was a matter of time. In 2021, the first Hualong 1 was launched, but since then 5 such units have been operating, 3 in China and 2 in Pakistan. And about a dozen more in China under construction. But let's finish with the description and look at this unit and the history of its construction. Here is the first stage, 2 CNP, 1000 units, the forerunners of Hualong 1. The second stage is similar to units 3 and 4. And now units 5 and 6, actually Hualong 1. They are visually larger. The fifth unit is the first in the history of Hualong 1, the third generation Chinese unit. Let's take a look at the entire station and its surroundings. Here is the cooling inlet on the left. On the right is a channel that drains water used for cooling. There are no cooling towers here, there is direct flow cooling, but seawater essentially acts as a third cooling circuit. The station is located on a small promontory in the Xinhua Gulf in the Taiwan Strait, between East China and South China Seas. About 3 million people live within a radius of 30 kilometers. Now let's look at the building's history. For convenience, expand the map. One of the most interesting features of Google Earth is the ability to look at maps for different periods. Here's what it looked like in 2006. No nuclear power plant here. Completely empty space. But the next picture for 2011 already shows the construction of the first 2 units. When did they start building? Let me show you another convenient service for those who are interested in nuclear energy. This is the IAEA database called Power Reactor Information System. We go to the section on statistics by country. Finding China. We find the Fuqing nuclear power plant of interest to us and specifically its first unit. Its name is shown here. Reactor type. His model. Even the owner and operator. Next is power. Net and gross, excluding own needs and taking into account. This is electrical power. Here is the heat output. Here is gross power, taking into account the unit's own needs. And here are the dates. Date of start of construction and pouring of the first concrete. This is the date of the first criticality. Date of connection to the grid and date of commissioning. The same can be found in Unit 2 and in any other NPP unit in the world. So, back to the 2011 satellite image. Now it is clear when which unit was started to be built and how old this construction site is in this picture. For about a couple of years. If you look in more detail, this circle here is the containment of the reactor compartment. These are nearby machine rooms with future turbines and generators. These are hydraulic structures that supply water for cooling turbine condensers. And here are the third and fourth units nearby. Here, in 2011, the work begins. The next available image is from early 2014. Externally, the first 2 units look ready. Construction work is completed, and equipment is being commissioned. Before the criticality of the first reactor, about 6 months, before its connection to the grid, another 7 months. For the second unit, this period is still almost a year and a half. In this picture, there is no fuel in the reactors yet. Here you can see the already completed domes of protective containments and turbine rooms. And here are the completed pumping stations. Let's look at units 3 and 4. In this image, they have been under construction for about 3 and 2 years, respectively. Here, on the fourth unit, the containment dome has not yet been installed. Here he lies and waits nearby. Let's see the next picture. January 2015, or in a year. Here the dome of the inner shell has already been installed. And the machinery hall has already been closed. And here is the fifth unit. Here, in fact, the start has not yet officially begun. Preparations are underway for pouring the first concrete into this round base, the foundation slab of the nuclear island. This will take place in a few months. This usually takes place as part of a solemn ceremony. We scroll further. A year later, the construction is already going very cheerfully. Several metal tiers of containment have been installed. And here is just an interesting period of construction, where you can trace the hydraulic channels. This is where the water will come from. Then, using the underground tubes, approach the machine hall, cool the turbine condensers, create the necessary vacuum, then go around the reactor compartment of the fifth unit. Similarly, around unit 6, here it is even better seen. And exit into the outlet channel. A month later, it is clear that the construction is growing. A year later, things are going on leading up to the closure of the reactor compartment of the fifth unit. And in the summer of 2017, 2 years after the start of construction, the dome of the inner shell is closed. Let me remind you that this is a two-layer reinforced concrete containment. There is an inner shell and an outer shell. First, a metal frame is placed, and then it is concreted. And so in two layers with a gap between them. For clarity, let's see how the installation of the metal dome of the inner shell took place. The mass of the part is about 400 tons. Here it is placed in its entirety. By the way, on modern Russian projects, such a dome is placed in two passes. Dome is installed in two parts, upper and lower. And the Chinese do it in one action. So, well, at this time, everything is ahead of the sixth unit, its dome is still lying on the ground. A year later, it was also installed. But what we see in the fifth unit is that the dome is already concreted. Looking wider, we notice an interesting point on the way. You see these flows in the discharge channels, this means that the first power units are already operating. Indeed, by 2018, all four first units were already in commercial operation. Beginning of 2019. On units 5 and 6 the domes are concreted. On the 5th, the dome of the outer shell is already visible. And, in 2020 the 5th unit is almost ready. On the 6th we see that the inner shell is concreted, and the metal frame of the dome of the outer shell still lies on the ground on the right. So, January 2021. The fifth unit has already passed the stage of criticality a couple of months ago, and by this moment it is actually already in commercial operation. In total, the construction of the first Chinese reactor of the third generation took a little more than 5 years. And this is a very good indicator by world standards. Here we can even see on the reset channel that the fifth unit is working. A couple of months later, there is a fresh image. You can look at other units and how they have changed. Well, this is the latest image available on Google Earth. So we won't see the entire completed station in the pictures, although in reality, the sixth unit started working last year and now the station is completely commissioned. Well, now let's look at it from the ground, and not from a satellite. Just the sixth and fifth units, which have already been completed, are closer to us and a perspective opens up on the first four units and the bay with wind turbines. View of the site. By the way, the platform is only 1.5 kilometers long and 700 meters wide, and the plant itself occupies only half of this width. I highlighted it in green. On the right, highlighted in yellow, there is a construction base with warehouses, equipment, machinery, and materials used in construction over all these years. All six units were built in 14 years. Here there is also a small pier for receiving equipment and cargo delivered by sea. Here you can still see the switchgear for the distribution of electricity from the station. It is closed and quite compact. Here are a couple of high-voltage power transmission towers. You can see how this power line goes from the station further to the peninsula and the mainland. Of the other buildings, of course, there is an administrative block. There is even a park and sports facilities, there is a village for builders, and then possibly for power plant personnel, as well as houses. Another football field. In short, everything for work and leisure, as expected. However, there are a couple of large cities within a radius of 30 kilometers where staff can also live. These are the city of Fuqing and the urban county of Fuxin, after which the nuclear power plant is named. In total, Several million people live in the district. Well, now let's take another look at the station and its construction from the ground. This is reinforcement and preparation for pouring concrete for the fifth unit. Installation of metal sections for concrete containment. First internal, then external. The installation of the dome, which we have already looked at. And this is the unit model and its internal structure. And inside the three-loop reactor plant. Three vertical blue steam generators, the red one is the actual reactor. And this is a real installation of one of the three steam generators. This is the reactor vessel. Branch pipes for the primary circuit pipeline are clearly visible. This is removing the automatic wrench to tighten the reactor lid. Engine room and turbine. Fuel loading, criticality, and power commissioning. Well, that's it, the station is in operation. As of February 2023, it is the third largest nuclear power plant in China and the sixth in the world. In total, six units have a capacity of 6,150 megawatts. Well, if you liked this video format, write in the comments what other nuclear power plants you would like to watch and study in the same way, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel, like the video, or even support me on Patreon. All links will be in the description. Goodbye.